men's semi-finals, we didn't see any of the teams going under 100 seconds. Can we see them do the same today? Again, if you look at the lineup, we do have a very, very strong only European finals. We have two Czech bikes, two from Poland, two from Germany, then Slovakia, French, GB, and Slovenia. I suppose a remarkable absence is the Hochschorners. I was trying to find out why they didn't actually turn up for the semi-final. And on the record, I couldn't get any information. I don't think there's any injuries. They're just one of those things that they're not here, so we have to accept it.
Yeah. We don't know. We don't have any valid information. They probably, one of them is feeling sick and they went home, prepare for the next races, or maybe they were on a fight after not so good qualification run.
Anyway, it doesn't matter. We have to see who we have here, and this is possibly the top pair at the moment. It's the young Slovenians, Luka Božič, 23 years old, Sasso Taljat, 24 years old. So far, they've been on fire. They won in Lee Valley three weeks ago, actually, in fact, and then silver last weekend in front of their home crowd. Let's see what they can do today.
Yes, they are very impressive from the beginning of the year. They already have a medal in the World Championship in Seoul.
And it's important for them to have a good result also here, because they are competing for overall standing of World Cup.
World Cup's clearly made up of five separate events. We started off with Lee Valley, then we went to Tatsun. Here we are this weekend. A bit of a pause for the summer, then beginning of August we go to the Olympic 1992 course in Spain, let's say that again. And then briefly afterwards we're in the World Cup finals in Augsburg in Germany. So a lot of racing yet to come.
Now they have a touch and they lost a bit of time in the upstream five. So now they're sure to take a lot of risk.
But they are known to have really fast times.
They're known also to very much coordinate their actions. Luka Božič is leaning back most of the time. Seems to work for them.
The ones sitting in front, he's racing C1-2.
He's had some great success. We're on the podium last weekend in Tatsun. Mm-hmm.
They was very fast on the difficult gates, 11-12.
Fastest time in the semi-finals, fastest actual time was 101.44, but this Skantar's had a 2 second penalty. And that gives us some sort of reference. They're dropping slightly low there, or will that be their tactic?
I think it was tactic, because they drop lower, they avoid the touch with the pole, and then the exit is faster because they gain some speed from the eddy.
It's a good run, maybe not enough for medals, we will see in the next competitors, but certainly a good time.
Well, here they go, last few strokes over the line.
The boat was jumping really on the finish line. They are satisfied.
Yeah, satisfied.
We can see the touch. It was on a gate where it's not very often.
Well, they're always.
They are going to regret this, I think.
34 pairs set out down to the top 10 as we see for the finals. And the seconds, well, it's one of the German pairs. Germans are often very strong in this event. It's Robert Berling and Thomas Becker. 23, 24 years old. Last weekend, good performance. Came fifth. They were the four German boats were in the finals, but none of them actually medaled. Let's see how they can do today.
First, the first upstream was good. Now they still have a lot of speed. Some troubles now.
They went a different way than most of the C2s.
Still no penalties.
Now they went too much into the stopper and it wasn't really fast.
They chose to have a straight trajectory, 11-12, the fast one.
Well done. Pretty much identical on the split time.
Who has more force in the second part of the venue? We will see Sasha Taliat or Luka Božić or
I know big troubles, no speed. Zelat, a lot of time now, many seconds.
Well, it's going to be tough to come back from that. The point of reference is 104.
And of course, they lost a lot of energy for the last upstream. And a touch now on the last upstream.
Well, the wheels have fallen off in the last half a minute or so. Surprised if that's going to bring a medal. 11 seconds off the pace with 6 seconds of penalties.
Yes, we can see two of the penalties probably at the end. They are not very happy with the run.
Would you say this course favours the back left or the back right, or is it fairly fair?
I wasn't thinking about it. I'm paddling K1, so...
Well, we'll have to analyse in the next few minutes. Next on the course, the
Polish
Brzezinski
guys.
Brothers.
Polish guys, there was not Polish in the finals in last week in Tarsen.
Still young in the under 23 worlds in Penrith, they came second, so they have some pedigree here. Let's see how perform on today.
Yeah, Polish are every time very strong nation in situ. The beginning now, it's good. I'm not sure they have a lot of experience in World Cup finals.
Well, in their best results is in 2013 in Tassin. They took a silver medal, I believe, in the under 23 worlds of 2013. Again, they did very well, but let's see how still in touch there. What's the 2 second penalty added before after the split time?
They touch the difficult gates number 12.
But they were even lucky they got in, so they had to touch in order to get in.
Now they lost a lot of speed. But the upstream 17 was good.
Now the front one is helping on the side of the guys in the back, and it paid off.
A little bit down, but still speed. They were probably not in the first position.
But as we can see, the fans are clapping hands even for other nations than Czech ones.
Well, just half a second off the pace, they provisionally move into second position. So far, we're a few seconds slower than the ladies were. Let's see if they can make up some time. They don't come much faster than this next pair, which is going to be David Florence and Richard Hounslow. They must have amazing memories coming down this course. Obviously, they won the World Championships last year in September here.
David Florence medaled also in C1 men, so...
And Richard Hounslow was in the final in K1, so now they know the course very well.
I guess so, because David came second yesterday. Richard made a couple of errors, so they've been down as many times as anyone else. Let's see how they go down.
His goal is definitely to be in top three.
Well, in London they came a fifth position, didn't compete last weekend in the C2 category.
Good upstream on the gates number 5. The big a 50 is missing the gates, unfortunately.
We could see that already on a gate before, because they were too on the right side and they were stuck in an eddy a bit and they had no speed.
We
you're in the right direction.
You're not going to need the slow motion camera to check that out. They missed it by a country mile, unfortunately. Well, that's game over. It does put Luka Bozic and Sasso Italia in a very favourable position. Physically, they're fastest on the course.
It's quite sad. They would be able to perform, I think, a really fast time.
Yeah, it's... They continue to bowling for the fun.
Great cheering from the local crowd as they know they're not a threat to the actual Czech teams there. And so it should be with the world champions.
Yeah.
They're still bowling good, but unfortunately with a 50.
As you can see, once you can be lucky on the course and second time you get a 50.
Other penalty, the downstream 21.
Academic at this stage.
It was a good time.
But I must give them credit that they finished the race in a speed and they were negotiating other gates like nothing happened.
Now we can see the mistake with the 50.
The water in this part is also changing a bit. I think the athletes were a bit surprised how the course changed after the last year.
You know, it's the C2 category, there is two people on the boat, so you should have a good coordination between the two paddlers. And when you're going out of the trajectory, it's very difficult.
Well, Czech competitors on the course, Kasper Sindler, Tatsun last weekend took the bronze medal, Lee Valley, eighth place. Very exciting crowd.
They are pretty successful. They are now coached by Wolf Stepanek. They were in training group with them last year and they retired after the World Champs in Prague. Now Stepanek is coaching them and I think he brought a new spirit into the training group and they really improved. And we can see they are
absolutely flying.
Yeah,
very fast. They know this course very well, so we can accept a big result for them here.
Now they are in front of the biggest crowd.
That's what people want to see.
Still a good run. Oh, touch on the right board of the upstream 13.
Gate 13 is tricky.
But Bozic Tyra have also a touch, so they can take the lead.
Good. Go away. Still, I don't know how was the split time, but...
A little bit faster. Oh, another mistake, unfortunately.
This wasn't necessary.
It's going to cost them at the end, but they are very, very fast. Let's see how they do. Time to go for 104. Well out, moves them down into provisional third place. They'll be regretting those 4 seconds of penalties.
They certainly should be a little bit disappointing with the last penalties. Now, the one was very good, but unfortunately, 2 touches.
Czech team has another representatives on a start line.
Well, we saw Lee Valley, a huge advantage for the Brits. We saw Tatsun, a huge advantage for the Slovenians. And rightly so, I guess, the local Czech paddlers have a bit of advantages. We saw Stepanek Higatovi just recently take a bronze medal. And we saw also, could you have scored the silver medal? There we go.
The Polish C2, they are very experienced.
Pokwile Stepanski, 31 years old, keeping the boat lovely and smooth. That's what they're known for. Let's see if they can do it today.
Right into the gate, number 5, really fast.
Good start. We will see what the judge says for the gate 8.
Well, it's a little bit breezy out there, but it
dirge for them.
A touch. But that's okay, they can still make up time.
Now they got a bit stuck in the stopper.
They will be late.
Great overhead pictures, you can see exactly where the speed of the water is going. 3.07 seconds off the touch at the moment. They're going to have to fly over the last section, but there is time to be made up.
Now the difficult part. It's looking good, they still have a lot of speed. Very fast.
That's the best we've seen so far today.
Now they are going on the last upstream.
Clean.
Yes.
And right into the gate.
Lot of speed still.
Well, it looks like we're going to see our new leaders, 104.63.
It's going to be a leap. Yes.
Provisionally, they move into the lead by 17 hundredths of a second.
There is still no C2 to make the final without penalties. The next C2 on the start will be the French. Nicolas Sianimanico and Hugo Cayol. Hugo have some trouble with his feet. 2 days ago, he was in the hospital. So we hope he will have a good form for the final. They are experienced in K1 and C1, but not so much in C2. It's her first final in World Cup.
Well, the French team obviously decided to mix and match and rest certain teams, certainly training camps, and drink certain here. So, Laborel, Pechier, Klaus, not here.
Klaus Pech, Hugo Bizot. They're training in Toulouse, in south of France. The start is good now. We will see if they make again a clean run, like in semi-final. It's looking for a good run.
This was the ideal way how to do it into the gate number 10.
Probably a touch. Yes, a touch on the left pole of the 11.
Still in touch there.
Yeah, they have a good time.
Hopefully they are gonna keep the boat moving like that. They look really in shape and the course is good for them.
It's still looking for very good run. It's the first final from them.
It looks really good.
Well, for the first final, this is certainly not bad.
Yeah, it's very good for first final. It's every time difficult.
They're not going to take the goal, but can they squeeze into a medal position? No, just outside.
However, it's very good result for this C2. Of course, they probably accept something better, but it's...
They have the start number 17, so I think they didn't expect... They were hoping to get into the final and everything else is...
The three top teams
success
left in the competition. Next to go, Germans have had a fun weekend. It's Franz Anton, Jan Benzien. They both made the final of the C1s yesterday. There's Franz came eighth and Jan came fourth. So they, as you mentioned before, they certainly know the course really well. Let's see how they go together today. Second German payoff.
Good start. Good start. Still very fast.
That was
a long
going around the gate.
Again, we will see what the judge say.
It was risky, but it doesn't.
They are definitely out of the trajectory. So we can see that the Polish C2 will have a medal. Now.
It's not going to plan. Well, only 2 seconds down at the split, so it's not pretty perhaps, but it seems to be going in the right direction.
They were risking too much on the beginning of the course, and I think they lost a bit focus, or they started to be nervous about it, and now they are slightly offline in almost each gate.
And as a penalty on the downstream 16, they take a lot of risk. Now the last upstream.
Local crowd cheering.
It will be not enough for medals today.
It's not quite happening. They did take a medal in the first World Cup of the season where they took silver last week. They also made the final, so they've made 3 finals in a row, but the Franz Anton's face tells the picture.
Not their day today.
Well, 2 competitors left, 2 teams left. We do know, as we mentioned, that Stepanski and Pochweiler have a medal for Poland.
Mm-hmm. And now we will see about Czech guys, Andrei and Jakub.
Well, they're known for liking to put on a show. Very young, very aggressive.
Mm-hmm. They break the paddle, if I have a good memory, in the first final in Livali.
Yes.
2 weeks ago.
Still came down without any penalties, so let's see how they can.
I think, and they were the only one without a penalty, I think.
Where they go?
Of course, they know this course very well. A good start. We can listen the public, the Czech public, a little troubles before the upstream 5.
Well, this is the last hope for a big medal, so let's see how it can go.
So far, so good.
They are still making a good run.
Well, it's looking good so far, keeping round number 10.
Yes.
Still no penalties.
Have to take a medal to be at least equal to their training mates.
Well, almost 3 seconds up at the moment. This is what the public want to see.
Hopefully they are, it's gonna stay like that until the finish line. Let's go, guys.
Crucially, still clear.
Still clear. A little troubles, but it's still enough for battles for the first part.
It was pulling them back in the stopper, and they lost the speed. And
well,
what do you think?
A couple of thousand Czech people are willing them on.
But they are still clean.
Still clean. It's going to be close. Look at the time. Here they come.
Now they have a black in front of their eyes and fourth.
Which shows how tight it is. We have now 4 teams within 1.5 seconds of each other. They were leading at the midpoint and then didn't manage to come through in the end. And they're the first team without any penalties. So their pure time was actually 3 seconds slower than Stepanski and Pochweiler.
They definitely lost it under the bridge here.
Bozy Stalite, who are actually second, will have also medal on World Cup this year.
Not a bad start, but if you're a betting person, maybe before the event you'd have said, well, it's going to be either the cousins or their twins, but the twins have not turned up to play today, so let's see how the Skantar cousins can perform. In their last 4 international outings, they have bronze, gold. So let's see how they can get it.
Amazing shape. And for them, it's really important to step out of the shadow of Oceaners.
It's the most impressive C2 from the beginning of the year.
That's going to give Sergio something to speak about.
The troubles in the downstream, seven, they touch the right pole.
Only a 2 second penalty there, so it's still very much a case of putting it forward.
We will see if they are going to be able to make the equal time to K1 women final times, because as well, we saw
very good time.
Well, 3 seconds up, it says that they are the team to beat.
They are not giving up.
Now the difficult part.
Good.
Still a lot of speed. It's looking very good for the first position. We will see how will be the last upstream.
Come past the iron. Just one more upstream to negotiate, then it's pedal to the metal. They do have some time in their favour.
Very good last upstream.
Well, barring disaster, they're going to give themselves. It's going to be really close. Yes, they've come home
incredible
by 2.16 seconds.
Incredible. Big congratulations to those guys, because to win in a row like this, they are European champions, then the Tatsun they won now again.
Well, last season it was the French's Klaus Bichet who dominated. The season before it was the other French's Bichet Lebarel, and so it's it seemed to have one team that dominates each season.
Yeah, and now we can see Skantar who dominated from the beginning of the years. They will probably have a very good position in the World Cup standing.
Well, it's quite simple. It's a two-horse race at the moment. It's Skantar's losing Bozic and Taliat, but certainly just three out of five competitions gone. Well, that's the major competitions. The confirmation of the result. Ladislav and Peter Skantar, the cousins, take gold for Slovakia. Piotr Stepanski and Marcin Pokwala take the silver for Poland. And Slovenia do have a bronze medal with Luka Bozic and Satio Taliat.
Unfortunately, no medal from the Czech C2 this afternoon.
Well, they can't win anything. You already have a medal in the C1 women and the K1 women, so it's a case of...
And K1 men also.
And K1 men also, yes.
It was a very amazing race. With a lot of penalties.
Shows it's been a difficult. So you, Eva, it's your local course. What are your thoughts on the weekend's racing? A lot of fun?
Definitely a lot of fun.
Etienne, it's your local, almost local course. Hopefully next time you can come back and get on the podium. But you've enjoyed it this weekend?
Yes, of course.
Well, that's pretty much the end of our weekend's activities. I hope you enjoyed yourself. Next time we're going to be coming live from the World Cup is going to be in Spain in just over a month's time, so that's going to be a lot of fun to look forward to.
Yes, in Cerro de Gil, in the Olympicos.
You like it there?
Yeah, I already won a World Cup there, so I'm looking for another medal there.
And over the rest of your season?
I will see if I'm doing Cerro. I hope I will be doing it, but the team leaders still haven't decided who will be joining the team, so...
It must be frustrating for yourself. You're one of the top paddlers in the world, but you haven't quite made it into the top three this season, so let's hope you... But you are a qualified pharmacist, so at least you have other interests in your life, so let's keep it going from there.
Yeah.
Well, thank you both for joining us today, adding your experience and insight into this live transmission. Bye-bye for us. See you next time, and thank you very much.
Goodbye.
Thank you, bye.